Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2242, Notes and Threaded Comments. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. A great update to this episode 2240A, where I complain about threaded comments. That episode is just 2 weeks old, and already Jon Peltier says, hey, you have to update the video. It's been fixed, and yes, it's been fixed, and thanks to Microsoft, and thanks to all of you who voted for my Excel.Uservoice idea. That this stuff has to come back. So today we're talking about notes. Now, I know that many of you think that notes are called comments, but that is just some weird thing. When notes debuted back in Excel 97, they were called notes. And then something happened in Excel 2000, they renamed them to be comments, and they were called comments up until last week. All right, but notes. So Alt-I-M brings up a little sticky note. Get the skim milk, please. It's the notes that we know and love forever. They are now called notes. All right, here they are, notes. So right now, show all notes, next note, previous note, new note. You just have to get over the fact that there was a bug in Excel and they called them comments for 20 years. They're back to their original name of notes, and they do all of the awesome things that they've always done. Dave Hawley's trick from the Excel Hacks book to change the shape of a note is still possible to do. Right, you can still do formatting, you can show all notes, you can change the shape, you can change the color. Notes are there, they're wonderful, and they're awesome, and thanks to Microsoft for bringing these back. It's not that notes were ever missing, it's just that they weren't on the ribbon, and people were going to assume that the new comments were the same as notes and destroy all the formatting. So I appreciate that notes is back. Okay, but now let's talk about the new thing, the threaded comments. These are cool. This is version 18.10 of Insider Fast, so it'll be hitting the monthly channel probably October, maybe November, or something like that. So I come here, instead of doing Alt-I-M to insert a note, I'm going to use New Comment. Now, these look like the old icons, but it's a completely new set of things. All right, so New Comment, see, it has my name, what flavor this week, and click Send. When I click Send, it date and time stamps the whole thing. All right, now let me run over to the other computer and I'll run right back. I'll pause the recording. All right, welcome back. Okay, so I ran over to the other computer and you can see there's now a reply to my comment. This is called threaded comments. You see who wrote it, the date, the time, what the comment was. And then I can add another reply. You can keep adding replies. All right, now notes and threaded comments can live side by side. You can tell one from the other. The little purple indicator means that there's a new threaded comment. The red indicates that there's an old style notes. Now, these icons here are for the threaded comments. These icons here are for the old notes. Notice what I just did there, the show hide all notes. Yeah, that only works for notes. When you do show comments, you're going to get something different. When you do show comments, you're going to get something different. You're going to get a panel over here with all of the comments. And then in theory, if I click on a comment, it's going to take me to that cell. All right, so brand new functionality. Looks really, really cool. After the stay around for the outtake, if you're interested in VBA, there's new VBA for these comments, and I'll put that at the end of the video. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like what you see in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. It's new VBA to do these, so we'll record a macro. And first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new comment. So this is a new comment. Perfect. Then I'm going to go back and reply to that comment. Perfect. Oh, I screwed something up. Let me go back and edit the original comment. And then we'll add a reply number 2. And I screwed something up, and I want to edit reply number 1. There we are, stop recording. Let's go take a look at that code. All right, so range A1, dot add comment threaded. This is a new comment. And then to add a reply, comment threaded dot add reply. To edit the original comment, comment threaded dot text, and then text colon equals this is a new comment edited. to add a reply. This is reply number 2 right now. So remember, we have comment, reply 1, reply 2, and then I went back and edited reply number 1. So that's commentThreaded.replies1.txt, and that's how we would edit in VBA. Simple enough, the old comment code will continue to work.